ever called home. And to hold out hope on shores beyond, like so many other men and women of mail, Edward and Patrick carried this hope with them across the sea. They settled in my hometown of Scranton, Pennsylvania, and Baltimore's sister city. As a matter of fact, I knew it was coming over. So you know what I did? I invited the mayor of Scranton, Pennsylvania, to come with me. He's here tonight. It was here, it was there in Scranton, where Patrick raised his own son, also named Edward. Edward Francis Willard, my great-grandfather. His Irish pride ran deep. He helped found the Irish American Association, now known as the Sons of St. Friendly Sons of St. Patrick of Lackawanna County. He shared Scranton, St. Patrick's Day Parade in 1897. For the ancient order of Hibernia. He became one of the first Irish Catholics ever elected to the Pennsylvania State Senate. And he became one of the first of my family to go to college, earning a degree in engineering from Lafayette College in Pennsylvania. But while Edward had the head of a scientist, he had the heart of a poet. Years ago, after my mom died, a lot of the belongings were in my attic. I couldn't get myself to go through them to empty the boxes. But what I finally did, you know what I found in the attic of my mother's keepsake? Over 100 poems written by Edward Blewett, Senator Edward Blewett. And one from 1919 he wrote of his Ireland. From the fairest land except my own, the stars and moon and sun, a citadel of liberty, my mother's land a room. Was his friend from her mom, Catherine Eugenia Finnegan. Met and married my dad. There was Mark Biden Sr. He was a wonderful man. But his saving grace in the eyes of the Finnegan was he had a Hanafy from Galway as his mother's side. It rescued the fact Biden's an English man. Together, they raised me and my siblings with a fierce pride in our Irish ancestry. Pride that spoke about the history, that binds us, but more importantly, the values that unite us. To this day, I can still remember hearing my dad say at the dinner table, Joey, and I mentioned this is, I give you my word as advice, this is absolutely true. He said, Joey, everyone is entitled to be treated with dignity and respect. I can still hear my mom say, tell me, Joey, nobody's better than you, but everybody's your equal. These are the same values I try to pass down to my children and grandchildren, whom I've always dreamed of bringing to Ireland. In 2016, when I was vice president, that dream became a reality. Three generations of my family walked along Garden Street, where Edward Blewett, a brickmaker and surveyor, lived with his family. It was on Garden Street we learned the true meaning of the Celtic expression, 100,000 welcomes. Matter of fact, I think I shook 100,000 hands that day. I also met the extended cousins, who instantly felt like family I'd grown up with on Sunday dinners on every single week. This strong bond brought me back in 2017 when I was a professor at the University of Pennsylvania. No crowds, no motorcades, no Secret Service. Just me and my brother Jimmy coming home to see family. During the trip, I had the honor of turning the sod at Roscommon Hospice. As many of you know, that hospice is now open. And thanks to my cousin, Loretta Blewett, and many of those, and she's incredible, by the way, and many of those, there's a marker laid there in remembrance of my son. Both passed away in 2015. A decorated war hero from Attorney General of Delaware after a valiant fight with brain cancer. So I can tell you how special it is at a place, a piece of his legacy lives here among his ancestors. And thinking about it, I can hear my dad's voice again. He always said, Joey, remember, family is the beginning, the middle, and the end. beginning, middle, and end. That's the Irish of it, the beginning, the middle, and end. Everything between Ireland and America runs deep. Our history, our heritage, our sorrows, our future, our friendship, our joys. But more than anything, hope is what beats in the hearts of all our people. For centuries, even during times of darkness and despair, hope has kept us marching forward toward a better future. One of greater liberty, greater dignity, and greater possibilities. In the earliest days of my nation's history, thousands of Scots-Irish alongside George Washington defended those ideals. And then, those democratic ideals were under threat during this, my nation's Civil War. That's when the Irish immigrants who came after the famine, more than 150,000 of them, joined the fight to defend the liberty and equality, many serving in the legendary Irish Brigade. When one other Irish Catholic president, only other one, John F. Kennedy, visited Ireland 60 years ago, you can clap for him, man. He was something else. He presented your parliament with a flag of the regiment of that Irish Brigade, honoring Ireland's great contributions to American freedom. It still hangs there to this day. It's a legacy of faith and fidelity to freedom, to one another, that's been handed down generation to generation to generation. Today, the United States continues to honor that legacy, including that one of a male-born Marine named Patrick Gallagher. Patrick immigrated to New York in 1962. He worked for the Senate campaign of one of my political heroes, Robert F. Kennedy. A few years later, when he wasn't even a U.S. citizen, Patrick joined the United States Marine Corps and deployed to Vietnam. In January of 1966, Patrick's team was attacked in an ambush. When the enemy hurled a grenade at his team, Patrick threw himself on top of that grenade. He was willing to sacrifice his life to save his brothers in arms. He survived that attack to David Woods and was awarded the Navy Cross for his bravery. Sadly, he was later killed in action. But this year, his name will be honored in iron as the United States launches a new Navy destroyer, the USS Patrick Gallagher, for Mayo. You know, I've often said that we Irish are the only people who are actually nostalgic about the future. We always believe in a better tomorrow because no matter what, we've always, always carried hope in our hearts. It's hope that lit the way through the darkness and lighted it for us. Our strength has helped us overcome everyday hardships. And above all, our courage has allowed us to march forward in faith, even in the face of sorrow and setbacks. As you know all too well, this is not just a story of our past, but our present and our future as well. Earlier this week marked 25 years since the signing of the Good Friday Agreement. 25 years of peace and progress, peace and prayer, not just with people of Northern Ireland, but people all across the island. It's a reminder of the importance of peace and what you can accomplish when we work together in common cause. Ladies and gentlemen, our world today stands at an inflection point where the decisions we make today are going to affect our future for decades to come. And it's in these moments where we need hope and courage more than ever. We're facing enormous challenges around the world. Challenges that are too great for any one country to solve alone. Together, we must take on these challenges of disease, food insecurity, which continue to devastate communities around the world, just as they did in Ireland generations ago. And I'm so proud to say that Ireland is not forgotten. We've stepped up as a leader to fight global hunger around the world today. We must tackle the climate crisis. It has devastating impact to preserve our planet for generations to come. As I said to the Parliament, Ireland's famous 40 shades of green now include green energy, green agriculture, and green jobs. Now, with Russia's brutal aggression, brutal war aggression, shattering the peace of Ukraine and in Europe, we must renew our commitment to our values our ancestors fought for. What do we Irish fight for? Freedom, democracy. It always must be defended. And I want to thank you. I mean it from the bottom of my heart. I want to thank you for your incredible generosity you've shown, like so many other Irish families across this country, who've opened up their hearts and homes to tens of thousands of Ukrainian refugees fleeing Russia's brutal violence. I've been there many times. Ireland remembers. Ireland remembers. Let me end where I began with the bricks of this cathedral. Only 200 years ago, the bricks cut by my great-great-great-grandfather and his hand still holds up this story day, holding aloft, like the Irish-American story itself, a testament to our shared past, present, and our future. It speaks to the sweat of the workers who raised the spire of skyward, brick by brick, just as they did in communities all across my home country. You know, over 32 million Americans claim of the Irish heritage, more would if they could. And I imagine all the hope and hard work embodying those Irish hearts inspired another one of my great-great-grandfather's understands in Bluett's poem. This one was from 1925, toward the end of his life. He called it The Workers. It goes like this. The march of progress cannot cease, while hearts and minds and ardent souls are bound in faith. It's a blind thing. My friends, people of Mayo, this is a moment to recommit our hearts, our minds, our ardent souls to the march of progress. To lay the foundation brick by brick by brick for a better future for our kids and our grandkids. One of greater liberty, opportunity, and dignity, just like our ancestors did for us. I've never been more optimistic, and I've been doing this a long time. I've never been more optimistic of what we can achieve if we stick together and stick to our values. This is a time of enormous possibility. And united by history, heritage, and hope, made most of all by courage, nothing is beyond our reach. Every time I walk out of my grandfather Finnegan's home in Strand, Pennsylvania, yelled, "Joey, keep the faith." Then I'd hear someone from the house yell, "No, Joey, spread it." May God protect all those who serve the cause of peace. And oh, one more thing. Mail for Sam!
There's not much to follow that, and with the music there playing in the crowd cheering, we're going to say goodbye to Mayo, to Ballina, and to U.S. President Joe Biden. After a very busy few days, and certainly a very emotional homecoming tonight, he returns to the United States later on this evening, goes through Dublin and back to the States tonight. But that's where we have to leave it from Ballina, and indeed from me here in the studio in Cork. But my thanks to all my colleagues, and until the next night, good night.